can't get along without.
Yes, there have been corrupt empires. Yes, they manipulate. Yes, there are secret societies. Yes, there have been oligarchies throughout history. And yes, today in 2002, there is a tyrannical organization calling itself the New World Order, pushing for worldwide government, a cashless society, open borders, total and complete tyranny, where human beings are absolutely worthless.
Ryan Garcia is one of the most popular, talented boxers in the sport currently. With his 10.6 million followers on Instagram, Ryan brings a lot to the sport of boxing. In fact, it was his following he created on YouTube that has traveled with him into the sport of boxing, similar to that of Jake Paul.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something your dog might do at the same time as you do it.
Go to the bathroom.
At what age do kids learn to share?
3.
His recent mega fight against Tank Davis reportedly sold 1.2 million pay-per-view buys as Ryan Garcia was stopped by a body shot in the 7th round. Ryan Garcia was able to return to the ring with his win against Oscar Duarte via stoppage. Now, with an upcoming bout against Devin Haney on April 20th, one would think that Ryan Garcia has everything to gain from a win against the sharp Devin Haney. Devin Haney has a lot to gain by agreeing to fight Garcia in the first place because of his immense social media following. The two have fought each other 6 times in the amateurs, the most recent time when they were 16, and split 3 wins apiece. Social media, as we all know, is a great tool for athletes in boxing as it is used as a great promotional tool. However, Ryan Garcia has everything to lose with some erratic sequences on his social media pages, primarily X, formerly known as Twitter.
NGQ, doing what I do. All white, looking nice, okay, come through.
I don't know if Ryan Garcia is taking the fight serious or not.
After Garcia's ex-wife posted her concerns, Ryan Garcia had taken the opportunity to explain his odd behavior.
Hey guys, it's me, Ryan. I'm coming on here to explain what's going on. I'm not in possession of my phone. I can't get access to my Instagram. My cards are locked. And I'm just being real, you know, being real taken advantage, and I personally wanted just to send out a video to the people that love me and my fans and family that's concerned that I'm okay. I'm not dead. I believe in Jesus. All those are lies, and you know, they try to put me in jail. They're blocking my cards. I can't access my money. Nobody's hitting me back. I don't know what's going on, but just know I'm okay.
Look. Shortly after that post, Ryan Garcia proceeded to open up Pandora's box on an X Spaces stream with Andrew Tate, a prominent online figure. Garcia talked about the disturbing things he was forced to watch at Bohemian Grove, like being tied to a tree and watching kids get raped. By opening up Pandora's box, the mission of this video is clear: to explain what Bohemian Grove is, the history behind the place, and how it ties into Ryan Garcia's accusations and where we are today as a society. On July 15, 2000, Alex Jones and his cameraman, Mike Henson, snuck into the Bohemian Grove and shot footage of the cremation of care ceremony.
The facility here has lost its power under these friendly trees. So shall we burn thee once again this night, and in the flames that eat thine effigy, we shall read the sign, Midsummer sets us free.
Ye shall burn me once again! Not with these flames, which hither ye have brought from regions where I reign. Ye fools and priests, I spit upon your fire.
Alex Jones said it was a ritual sacrifice. It turns out that the Bohemian Grove has a long history, as it was founded in 1872 in San Francisco, California. This club includes prominent businessmen, musicians, former U.S. presidents, predominantly Caucasian men coming together to discuss future policy while doing ritual sacrifices and praying to Moloch. Members include former presidents Eisenhower, Richard Nixon, and Ronald Reagan. The Bush family has strong ties to the Grove. Former President George H.W. Bush was a member of the elite Skull and Bones secret society cult. In fact, during the 2004 presidential election, both the Republican and Democratic nominees, John Kerry and President Bush, were Skull and Bones members.
What happened to Skull and Bones, the secret society?
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go on.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322?
First of all, he's not the nominee. Look, I look forward...
Are you prepared to lose?
No, I'm not going to lose.
You both were members of Skull and Bones, a secret society at Yale. What does that tell us?
Not much, because it's a secret.
Is there a secret handshake? Is there a secret code?
I wish there were something secret I could manifest.
322, secret number?
There are all kinds of secrets, Tim, but one thing is not a secret. I disagree with this president's direction that he's taking the country.
Some people believe that the group is influenced by the Illuminati and is controlled by the CIA. In the first 50 years of the club's existence, the Bohemian Grove was accessible to outsiders. But in the 1930s, as the club gained influence, it became a secretive gathering with many powerful people, whom most believe is shaping the world into a new world order. J. Robert Oppenheimer is known as the father of the atomic bomb. The Manhattan Project was the name given to the enterprise to build the atomic bomb. It is said that Oppenheimer attended a private event at the mysterious Bohemian Grove Club in 1942, where he first discussed the Manhattan Project. The historical ramifications of the creation of the atomic bomb has changed our world today. The atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, two Japanese cities, killing 140,000 in Hiroshima and 74,000 in Nagasaki, with many of the survivors dying with cancer and other terrible side effects due to the radiation. With all that being said, Christopher Nolan, the director of Oppenheimer's biopic, decided to leave the Bohemian Grove details in correlation to the Manhattan Project out of this movie. Maybe Christopher Nolan wanted to avoid controversy? Or maybe he is a part of that cabal. What I mean by cabal, I mean secret societies. Secret societies such as the Skull and Bones, Freemasonry, in which 13 of 39 men who signed the Constitution were a part of, and the most notable Illuminati secret society. A secret society that was created in 1776 in Europe, who many believe have been working undercover to take down federal government to shake the world into a new world order. Most people think these groups were responsible for the world-shifting events like the JFK assassination in 1963, in which 65% of Americans believe it involved a conspiracy. Some people believe that the 1963 moon landing was fake to cover up evidence of alien existence. There are even theories that the same cabal had their imprint on 9/11, therefore it being an inside job, and today with the COVID shots as well. But whether or not y'all believe that they are secret societies running the world, and whether or not you believe Ryan Garcia's side of the story with his own personal experiences at the Bohemian Grove, it has already been proven that this place exists. We may never know if Ryan Garcia's accusations of being tied to a tree at the Grove and watching kids get raped is true, but what we do know is the trafficking of kids and women all around the world is going on. Politicians are involved. Celebrities are involved. Jeffrey Epstein, before his alleged suicide, was faced with a series of serious sex trafficking charges in a case that took the country by storm, considering the ramifications of high-profile public figures involved. Allegedly, former President Bill Clinton visited Epstein's island in the Caribbean, better yet known as Pedophile Island, where he had dinner with two girls who looked like sisters. Court documents allege that the then 17-year-old Virginia Roberts was forced by Epstein to have sex with Prince Andrew on several occasions, including as part of an orgy on Pedophile Island. In a lawsuit filed by Virgin Islands Attorney General Denise George, she accuses Epstein of bringing girls in between the ages of 12 and 17 to his $577 million estate by boat, helicopter, and plane between 2001 and 2019. The air traffic controllers in the Virgin Islands said that they saw Epstein leave his private plane with girls who looked 11 years old in 2018. As per an email sent by Epstein to Maxwell, which was part of unsealed documents, scientist Stephen Hawking had taken part in an underage orgy on the island. Nevertheless, one thing about this episode was clear. If you were an A-list celebrity, you had access to underage girls at Epstein Island. Jeffrey Epstein, after being arrested, was found dead in his cell with a bedsheet tied around his neck in 2019, as his death was pronounced as a suicide by medical examiners. But despite being in government custody, he died. One person that we can call the Epstein of hip-hop is P. Diddy. Considered to be one of the most influential people in the music industry, who has had a reputation for throwing star-studded parties. But over the last couple of months, he has been the focal point of multiple lawsuits that has alleged sexual violence, physical abuse, and sex trafficking. The accusations span more than 30 years back to the 90s, where Combs was a producer at Uptown Records. Former R&B singer Cassie opened up Pandora's box with a lawsuit. She met Combs when she was 19 and he was 37, and they dated from 2007 to 2018. Cassie accused Combs of forcing her to participate in sex parties in which Combs made her and his employees fly male sex workers to multiple cities in the United States. Another suit filed by Rodney Jones, a music producer who worked on Puff's The Love album, claimed that he was forced to perform sex acts to the pleasure of Puff from 2022 to 2023. Diddy's legal battles started to heat up as two of his mansions were raided by Homeland Security. The raids were conducted as a part of a federal sex trafficking investigation. Laptops, cameras was confiscated. Diddy, however, was on his plane and private jet heading to the Caribbean. Now, here's an interesting correlation between Diddy and Epstein that will have you thinking. Back on Kanye West's interview with Drink Champs, he called Diddy a fed.
Mills, Puff Daddy, whoever, none of these niggas. All you fake hard niggas, fuck you.
Wait, hold on.
Okay. All you fake hard niggas, fuck you. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck because you can't shoot nobody anyway. And the reason why you got talks is because you did a deal, you fucking fed.
We do know, or we should know, that Diddy's dad cut a deal with the feds as well. Upon doing research, I realized that there were some suspicions that Epstein was working for Mossad, an Israel intelligence agency. Israel's former prime minister, Ehud Barak, was identified in Epstein's list of associates. Barack met with Epstein 36 times and was pictured entering his Manhattan townhouse with a scarf around his face in 2016. Young women were seen coming in and out of the residence that same day. Former Israel spies have gone on record stating that Epstein's international sex trafficking was an entrapment operation, gaining valuable material to blackmail politicians and business elites. Jasleen Maxwell was Epstein's right hand, currently serving a 20-year sentence for her role in the trafficking. Her father, Robert Maxwell, is alleged to have been a Mossad agent and may have provided the link between Epstein and the Israel Intelligence Agency. In fact, Jasleen's father, Robert Maxwell, had a mysterious death 30 years ago when he fell to his death from his $15 million yacht. There's a theory that Robert asked the agency for $400 million and the intelligence agency refused to pay him and feared he would expose them, and they probably had something to do with his death. Now, back to Kanye West's comments about Diddy being a fed.
Mills, Puff Daddy, whoever, none of these niggas. All you fake hard niggas, fuck you.
Wait, hold on.
Okay. All you fake hard niggas, fuck you. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck because you can't shoot nobody anyway. And the reason why you got talks because you did a deal, you fucking fed.
Is it possible that Diddy, whose father was known to work for the feds, is part of the same agency that Jeffrey Epstein is a part of? Boxer Ryan Garcia responded to the raid saying they were raiding to hide more. So what we need to do is pray for the law enforcement to grow some balls and leak out what's really there. Diddy's the puppet, Ryan Garcia said. What we do know is laptops, video cameras were confiscated. Diddy's love producer, Lil Rod, said in his affidavit that Diddy had every room taped and bugged. Secret tapes that contained different celebrities and politicians. Ryan Garcia went as far as to troll Devin Haney, posting a picture of topless Haney and Diddy together in a swimming pool. In a recent interview with the Spit Bucket podcast, Ryan Garcia alleged that Ye declined to accompany him during his ring walk for the upcoming fight against Devin Haney due to Garcia's past comments mocking Diddy over serious allegations.
I was trying to cancel Diddy. I'm like, bro, Diddy canceled himself, dog. What are you talking about? Weren't you the same one that literally was talking about Diddy and said that he was a fed? What happened to that? That's what I'm saying. Like, like I said, we just got to pray for him because he's obviously tripping.
Yeah, I'm really confused on why Ye is defending Diddy. There's just way too much stuff coming out about Diddy. Like, way too much.
Yeah.
It don't look good.
It's only going to get worse. I mean, it's not going to get any better. I mean, the feds are on you. I mean, that doesn't just happen. You understand what I'm saying? Like, nobody just... I know people are like, no, that does happen. But, like, the feds are on you. Obviously, they have some type of, you know, evidence or warrant to even raid your house. Like, nobody could just... raid your house without any type of evidence. You understand what I'm saying?
But if he doesn't get charged, I think that's confirmation that he is, in fact, an informant.
100%. 100%.
Everything we've discussed so far in many ways are connected, even down to the open borders that are allowing illegal immigrants to enter the country. The border has remained the top political issue as people are entering the United States unverified, drug traffickers, sex traffickers, and murderers. Six migrants were accused of jumping a pair of officers in Times Square before taking off to California. These thugs were also involved in a larger conspiracy in which they used Apple Pay on stolen phones to buy cars and pools. An FBI and U.S. Border Patrol task force recently arrested a woman who goes by the name Lachelle at an El Paso motel in a border case. Lachelle was wanted in Mexico for leading an ultra-violent gang that cut the hearts out from dismembered bodies of victims as offering to La Santa Muerte. The 22-year-old woman is accused of taking part in five homicides in Mexico. She was part of a gang crew that was notorious for such crimes in Mexico. So let me get this straight. An alleged murderer on the run and part of a dangerous gang in Mexico was able to illegally cross the border, not to mention her smuggling guns, knives, machetes, and drugs such as heroin, cocaine, and Xanax. A migrant influencer who crossed the border illegally in 2022 was seen on TikTok calling for others to invade U.S. homes. He admitted to getting paid $350 a week from the federal government. Children are being trafficked through the border and being sent on vans after leaving the airport. Everything from Alec Jones' video has been coming to pass, including when he talked about the open borders, which are extremely relevant at this moment. The question is, what's the goal for allowing these borders to be open in the first place? I have my theories, but I'm not here to sway public opinion. I'm here to produce the facts. All this ties back to Ryan Garcia's accusations, highlighting the Bohemian Grove, a place where the direction of the country is decided by a small group of men that control the United States, control the president, and certain celebrities. With Ryan Garcia's influence and a big fight against Devin Haney coming up, spilling the beans at this time, followed by a potential victory, could make him an even bigger star than he already is.
That's a Fugazi, all right?
That's a Fugazi? How do you know it's a Fugazi? You looked at it for 2 seconds.
Well, it's a fake.
But yeah, I know what a Fugazi is.
Hey, pal.
See something?